Hello, welcome to Newsclick. This is election season and Newsclick has been traveling in Kashmir for last 1 month. We have been speaking to young voices from different backgrounds, but to really understand what Kashmiri youth aspires, we are joined by three students from different universities of Delhi. Let me welcome
Ejaz Ahmed Rathar from JNU, who is also the General Secretary of JNSU. Misbah Reshi from Law Faculty, Delhi University. Saki Parvez from St. Stephen College. Okay, let me begin with you, Ejaz. Local reports and Newsclick reports, they suggest that the youth of Kashmir is feeling dejected and alienated. They don't believe in electoral politics. What do you want to say about that?
This is certainly a fact in Kashmir. The youth, especially the youth, they does not believe in electoral politics. It is because if you will see from last three decades consistently, there is a like mass suffering in the Kashmir, and there is a blatant the oppression of the state that is happening in Kashmir. And now if you will see from 2014, since the coming of this Modi government, consistently the Modi government failed in Kashmir vis-a-vis due to his muscular politics. And now if you will see consistently from 2014, Modi government is against the constitutional validity that was given to the Kashmir. If you will see the Article 35A, Article 370 is being consistently attacked. And now you can see the new BJP manifesto, what is called as Sankalp Patra. If you can see how much that is based on that kind of muscular nationalism and how the hate campaign is being done on that kind of manifesto. If you can see recently, you can listen to the speeches of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, Amit Shah, as well as the BJP veteran leaders like Jaitley and all that, how they are consistently speaking against Article 35A and Article 370A. In spite of that, if you will see consistently, the academicians from the valley as well as the intellectuals from the rest of the India, as well as in fact the left has spoken that how Article 35A and 370 has the constitutional validity and how it is come with that kind of political process. But We did not know why the BJP is going, its manifesto is going against the constitution. And like if you can see last time how Narendra Modi in his rally in election campaign in Kutwa, how he was speaking like the language of RSS. That is totally non-acceptable. And now how the youth will come towards the electoral politics, that is a question. If there is alienation, how we will address the alienation? So the center has failed particularly in Kashmir, whether it is BJP, in fact, before that, if you will see, if it was a Congress, how the regressive forces are being implemented in Valley. There is a ban on civil traffic in Kashmir. And now, how much draconian is that?
Ejaz said that the center has failed in Kashmir. I want to ask you, what about the state government? What about the regional political parties?
And definitely, they too have failed the people of Kashmir, especially the youths of Kashmir. And had they not failed us, had they not failed the youths, and I don't think Kashmir would be at a point it is now. We see the daily recurrence of killings, and definitely it's because of the apathy of the state government towards the youths of Kashmir, towards the people of the Kashmir. Had they been more accountable, had there been an element of accountability in the state government, into the armed forces, I think we, as the youths of Kashmir, may, you know, increase our confidence in the, into the electoral politics of the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Otherwise, I don't think the people, of, especially the youths, they are drifting away from the electoral politics, and the apathy and the helplessness of the state government is and drifting the youth towards the violent political recourse.
Misbah, I would like to ask you, he said that the state government and the failure of state government is drifting the youth away from the electoral politics. How do you see it? Because do you think, as Ejaz said, that it's the BJP government that has drifted the youth away? Is it only the BJP government or the failure of the whole state machinery?
I think it's both. The state and the central government, we cannot overlook the fact that it's not that there things were better when Congress was in power, and you know, since BJP things have gotten worse. It's just that BJP has a certain kind of political agenda that is anti-Muslim, that also adds a certain kind of baggage and a burden on Kashmiri Muslims. But in terms of addressing the problem in Kashmir, I think whether it's Congress or BJP, whether it's a national conference or PDP, I don't think anyone has been able to adequately address what is happening. And because of that, I agree with Saqib, the youth is feeling dejected and disenfranchised and looking at alternative methods.
Saab, batayen ki kya kya alternative methods ho sakte hain ya hai jo youth ko follow karne chahiye?
सी फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल जो अल्टरनेटिव मेथड्स की बात है, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कश्मीर में ये है कि क्या वहाँ पे डेमोक्रेसी और जो प्रोसेस होती है डेमोक्रेटाइजेशन की, वो किस तरीके से वहाँ पे सस्टेन किया जाए। इफ़ यू कैन सी फ्रॉम लास्ट 4 decades कश्मीर में डेमोक्रेसी को रखा ही नहीं गया है, डेमोक्रेसी को चांस ही नहीं दिया गया है। एंड कश्मीर हैज़ बीन टेकन ऑनली ए वन बॉर्डर स्टेट, और यही हमेशा कहा जाता है इफ़ यू रिमेंबर द आर्गूमेंट, क्योंकि ड्यू टू द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ सिक्योरिटी एंड ऑल दैट द रीजन इज़ नॉट एबल फॉर ए डेमोक्रेसी। फर्स्ट थिंग इज़ दैट डेमोक्रेसी को किस तरीके से आप मीनिंगफुल बनाएंगे। इफ़ यू कैन सी द मेन स्ट्रीम पार्टीज इन कश्मीर हैव ऑफन बीन टूथलेस, उन पे का कोई चीज़ नहीं रहता। द सेकेंड थिंग इज़ नाउ द यूथ bringing द यूथ ऑन द ट्रैक, इट इज़ लाइक द फर्स्ट थिंग इज़ द पॉलिसीज, जो पॉलिसीज़ है वो किस तरीके से फ्रेम किया जाए वहाँ पर। द सेकेंड थिंग इज़ ऐसी पॉलिसियाँ फ्रेम किया जाए की जाए कि जो ना मस्कुलरिज्म नेशनलिज्म पे बैठी हो, एक भरोसा दिया जाए, एक डिग्निटी दी जाए, एक इज्जत दी जाए।
हम बहुत समय से भरोसे की बात कर रहे हैं। थर्ड थिंग इज
नाउ द थर्ड थिंग इज द इंस्टीट्यूशंस, द इंस्टीट्यूशंस इन कश्मीर, द इंस्टीट्यूशंस इन कश्मीर आर करप्ट। एक इंस्टीट्यूशन को अपना जो इंडिपेंडेंट उसका ऑटोनॉमी है वो उसको रखी जाए। इफ यू कैन सी द करप्शन इन द कश्मीर, इफ यू कैन सी द डिसफंक्शनिंग ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूशंस, ऑल दैट हैज एलिनेटेड। एंड द थर्ड मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज अपस्पा, यूज ऑफ पैलेट्स, यूज ऑफ दोज सच काइंड ऑफ वेपन्स को किसी जगह दुनिया में अभी यूज़ नहीं होते जो वेपन्स यूज होते हैं। एंड द फोर्थ थिंग इज नाउ जो रिसेंट बैन आई है हैवे पर, आप रोड्स को हैवे को आप स्टॉप कर रहे हैं 2 दिन के लिए सिविलियन को, तो किस तरीके से यूथ आ जाएगा, किस तरीके से पॉलिसीज आएंगे? तभी ना आएगा ना जब सेंटर में चेंज होगा, एक पॉलिसी लेवल में चेंज होगा। जो एलिनेशन की बात हम कर रहे हैं या बार बार जो एलिनेशन का आर्गुमेंट आ रहा है तभी वो खत्म हो सकता है, लेकिन अभी तो हमको आई डू नॉट थिंक अभी ये कुछ बीजेपी के मंशा में ये कुछ है।
लेट मी गो टू साकिब, ही सेड अपस्पा, डोंट यू थिंक द डी मिलिटराइजेशन शुड बी द फर्स्ट थिंग, एंड ऑल्सो द पोलिटिकल पार्टीज, द मेनी पोलिटिकल पार्टीज हैव कम टू पावर, इन देयर मैनिफेस्टो जो सबसे पहली बात वो लिखते हैं, वो लिखते हैं डी मिलिटराइजेशन, बट दैट इज नेवर ऑकर्ड, दैट इज नेवर हैपेंड। व्हाट डू यू वॉन्ट टू से अबाउट दैट?
Well, I think the military measures that a state extends to any problem, they only act as painkillers. The long-time solutions to any conflict, they come through a political outreach, through a humanitarian aspects. As you know, Vajpayee ji was so revered in Kashmir Valley, he is famous into the separatist circles also. But despite Vajpayee ji being very dear to the current prime minister, he is doing complete reverse to what he did. There was a drift towards the mainstream politics, towards the electoral politics in Vajpayee ji when he announced the confidence building measures with the separatists, with the youths of Kashmir, and that's what I think should be done in the valley, so that the youths are, we can bring back youths towards the mainstream politics. Because once we take part in the mainstream electoral politics, it is only then we can find solution to our problems. It is not that even though electoral politics has been, you know, it is sort of defunct. It has been rendered what we call as irrelevant. But yes, we need to get youths back to the mainstream politics so that this conflict can be avoided. The daily recurrence of killings can be avoided. And yes, as I say, military measures they only act as painkillers, not the long-term solutions.
Military measures as painkillers, youth drifting away from the politics, electoral politics, emotion of Azadi raging. What do you want to say about that?
I think firstly, with respect to policies, I just want to add that there have been certain measures that the center has taken. So, for example, you had the Prime Minister Scholarship Scheme, or you had certain helplines that were set up in order to address whatever was happening to Kashmiris. And how those policies also, although I don't know what the real intention was, but on the face of it, intended to sort of address the problems that Kashmiri youth faces when they, you know, where your intention is to sort of integrate them in your mainstream India. All those policies have also failed because those helpline numbers haven't worked. How a lot of students that have gone through Prime Minister's scholarship scheme haven't received the funds, haven't had to go back because, you know, the university said that we haven't received the money. So Kashmiri youth is also then feeling that, you know, our problems aren't being addressed. And obviously the narrative of Azadi, who is going to address that narrative? I mean, we cannot keep engaging with state governments and parties that exist in Kashmir without also engaging with this narrative of Azadi. We cannot say that this is something that isn't a regional political sort of identity that the youth holds, and just say that this is, you know, something that's sponsored. I think unless and until we address that, you cannot holistically address the Kashmiri problem.
Ijaz, what we saw after Pulwama attack, what we saw that how Kashmiris were thrown out of the colleges, suspended, how they came back to Kashmir. Do you think that the aftermath of Pulwama attack created a wedge between Kashmiri youth and India?
Oh, definitely. If you can see, that was especially a Prime Minister's special scheme was started to take Kashmiri youths outside to the Kashmir, and they will see the rest of the India. They will see, they will get the exposure and all that. But when they came out and they have been, after the Pulwama tragedy, they have been beaten here by some hooligans, by some RSS, by some activists, some in the different places of India. The first important thing is they went back, but with what message? They went back to the valley. Kaun sa message leke wo valley mein wapas chale gaye? That is the most important question. And second thing is, we have also written for that ki ek attack wahan par hota hai, but how the students have been attacked here, aur kis tarike se actually wo media mein pichle 4 saal se continuously picture create kiya gaya hai. Media mein, BJP, RSS, baki kis tarike se ek hate campaign chalaya gaya, aur endlessly jo bhi gussa aa raha tha, and you can see the governor Tathagat Rai, you can see his statement, Kashmir ko ban kar do, ban everything, business ban kar do, you can see in Bihar.
Agar BJP, Ijaz, main aapse ek bahut zaruri sawal puchna chahungi, agar BJP center mein fir se wapas aa jati hai, ye Kashmir ko kis tarike se affect karegi? Kal humne dekha Kathua rally mein Narendra Modi ne kya kaha tha, he invoked Shyama Prasad Mukherjee there. What do you want to say about that?
से देखिए, डेफिनेटली बीजेपी का एक है, एक पॉलिसी है बीजेपी का जो आइडियोलॉजिकली है, जो जनसंघ से आता है, एंड इन विच जनसंघ क्लियरली सेज दैट कि हम आर्टिकल 370 को नहीं मानते हैं, हम 35A को नहीं मानते हैं, एंड दैट लॉजिक कम्स फ्रॉम द आरएसएस. आरएसएस कभी हिंदुस्तान के कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन को नहीं मानता है, एंड दैट इज डेफिनेटली वट नरेंद्र मोदी इज़ फॉलोइंग. सो जो लास्ट उनका रैली हुआ है, हम उसके बोलना चाहते हैं कि इन 1953 श्यामा प्रसाद मुखर्जी का जो मोबिलाइजेशन था, जो एजिटेशन था, दैट हैज़ बीन रिजेक्टेड बाय द पीपल ऑफ जम्मू कश्मीर एंड लद्दाख. उस वक्त जब उसका स्लोगन था एक प्रधान एक विधान एक संविधान, उस वक्त भी द पीपल ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर हैव रिजेक्टेड इट, एंड वी आर बिलीव एंड वी बिलीव इन अवर पीपल दैट कि इफ नरेंद्र मोदी गवर्नमेंट कम्स अगेन, द पीपल ऑफ जम्मू कश्मीर एंड लद्दाख विल अगेन रिजेक्ट सच काइंड ऑफ स्लोगन्स एंड दैट Sangh's ideology. Article 370 and Article 35A has a strong constitutional and political backing, and there is no force in the India who can abrogate such kind of articles. And the fourth thing is, these articles are most important for the culture as well as for the identity of Kashmir.
What about the Jammu youth? I would ask this question to all of you. What about the Jammu youth? Jammu youth sees the 370 article in 35A differently. How they see it has been evident in the last 4 years. It has come to the fore. You know, in the aftermath of Pulwama attack, we saw what happened in Jammu with Kashmiris. So what about the Jammu youth? How do you see that?
See, most important thing is, if you can see, after the coming of this BJP government center, what happened was most unfortunate, that they were trying to make a gap. जम्मू को कश्मीर के खिलाफ भड़काना, लद्दाख को उसके खिलाफ भड़काना, दैट हैपेंड इन लास्ट 3 years. पर्टिकुलरली बीजेपी जो जिस तरीके का इसका कम्युनल पोलराइजेशन है वोटिंग के लिए, एंड दे कंसंट्रेटेड मोस्टली ऑन द हिंदू डोमिनेटेड एरियाज इन जम्मू, एंड दैट इज हैपनिंग नाउ. बट सी, इन दिस टाइम आई थिंक वी द पीपल ऑफ जम्मू कश्मीर एंड लद्दाख हैव टू कम टुगेदर, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल बाई रिजेक्टिंग द बीजेपी इन जम्मू कश्मीर एंड लद्दाख इन दिस इलेक्शन, एंड द सेकेंड थिंग इज टू वी हैव टू talk to each other, because we are dependent towards each other on the basis of business. Kuch yahan log rehte hain, kuch wahan log rehte hain, and there certainly is ki jo bhi communal elements hai, whether Jammu mein hai, Ladakh mein hai, Kashmir mein hai, we have to reject that, and the youth has to understand that.
आपको लगता है साकिब कि इस बारी बस बीजेपी को रिजेक्ट करने के लिए जो कश्मीरी लोग हैं वो बाहर आके वोट करेंगे?
आर्टिकल 370 इज अंडर अटैक, आर्टिकल 35A इज अंडर अटैक, एंड द वे यू कैन सेव इट इज by a meaningful response. And what the meaningful response has to be, it has to be decided by the youths. As I say, that both the Hurriyat camp and the mainstream camp, they should come together, they should cut some slack, and start a meaningful process in this regard as to how to save their identity, because this is the only bridge between India and the Kashmir, and it has the constitutional validity. And attacking this means the attacking of the Kashmiri identity, and also there has to be a dialogue between the youths of Jammu and the youths of Kashmir, and the sooner we do it, and the sooner we can see a change.
Dialogue between youth of Jammu and youth of Kashmir, what do you think?
I think that the youth of Jammu and the youth of Kashmir both have distinct political identities, and both these identities carry a lot of baggage. So I think the kind of experiences that a Kashmiri youth has had living in Kashmir and a Jammu youth has had living in Jammu is drastically different because of the situation in Kashmir. I think the kind of, again, like as he said, hate mongering has been going on, has created a vast difference between these two groups. But obviously there needs to be a meaningful dialogue so that they are able to see that, you know, what is happening in Kashmir and why are they, you know, behaving a certain way, why is their political identity a certain identity, and why is it different from the Jammu identity. I think addressing the difference of identity will only be a way forward to then sort of addressing how they can come together.
Ejaz, in the rest of the country, if we see, Kashmir has always been seen through the lens of encounters. And the youth, when we speak of youth khali violence nahi chahta hai. To youth ke aspirations kya hai? Main chahti hu aap uske bare mein ek detailed tarike se bataein ki youth ke aspiration kya hai, youth chahta kya hai.
Actually, this picture has been created by the Godi media consistently, if you can see. जो कुछ थोड़ा सा भी कुछ होता है कश्मीर में, तो यू कैन सी वंस ए शो स्टार्ट्स ऑन कश्मीर, यू कैन सी ए मैन, यू कैन सी ए स्मॉल चाइल्ड, आर ही इज़ कमिंग विद हिज मास्क ऑन हिज फेस एंड ही इज़ बेल्टिंग स्टोन्स एंड ऑल दैट. सो पहले तो वो है कि जो मीडिया है उसको, मीडिया हैज़ टू रन इन कश्मीर बाय फॉलोइंग हिज एथिक्स. That is the most important thing. The second thing is, जिस आप जो कहते हैं कि youth के जो aspirations है, certainly जिस तरीके से पूरी दुनिया के youth के aspirations है कि हम पढ़े, we want a good life, a prosperous life, उस तरीके से कश्मीर में भी है. But जानबूझ के ये हिस्टीरिया क्रिएट किया गया है कश्मीर में. If you can see, that's वो कंसिस्टेंटली हम कह रहे हैं कि फॉर कमिंग कश्मीर इन टू नॉर्मल सी, यू तुमको अपस्पा हटाना होगा, तुमको रीजन को डिमिलिटराइज करना होगा, एंड देन यू हैव टू गिव दैम ए डिग्निटी, तुमको स्पेशल स्कॉलरशिप देने होंगे इफ रीजन विच इज सफरिंग कंसिस्टेंटली फ्रॉम लास्ट 40 ईयर्स ड्यू टू कन्फ्लिक्ट, वाई देर आर नो स्कॉलरशिप फॉर कश्मीर इज इन एवरीवेयर, इन द सेंट्रल यूनिवर्सिटीज, इन डिफरेंट इंस्टीट्यूशन एज वेल एज इन IITs. ये सब होने चाहिए, और सम स्पेशल पॉलिसीज होनी चाहिए टूवर्ड्स द यूथ, हाउ वी कैन, हाउ दे विल कम टू द इंडिया, हाउ दे विल सी इट, कि क्या है बाहर, क्या चल रहा है. मतलब एक बंद कर दिया गया है लोगों को, एक लैंड लॉक टेरिटरी में आप बंद कर रहे हैं, और दिल्ली में जो मीडिया चाह रहा है वो चला रहा है कश्मीर के नाम पर. तो सर्टनली दीज जो पहले पॉलिसीज़ है, एक पॉलिसी लेवल में चेंज आना चाहिए, वो मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट चीज़ है. और उसके बाद जो एस्पिरेशंस हैं, नॉर्मली यूथ का पढ़ाई का एस्पिरेशन है, दे वांट ए प्रॉस्परस लाइफ, दे वांट ए गुड एजुकेशन, एंड यू कैन सी इन कश्मीर, मतलब किस तरीके से.
पर आपको नहीं लग रहा कि कश्मीर में ये जो आपने एस्पिरेशंस मेरे को बोली कि हमारी नौकरी हो, हमारी गुड लाइफ हो, हमारे पास एक घर हो, ये नॉर्मल एस्पिरेशन, पर आपको लगता है इससे हटकर भी कुछ एस्पिरेशन है कश्मीर की, कश्मीरी यूथ की?
सी सर्टनली कश्मीर इज अ पॉलिटिकल क्वेश्चन, देयर इज नो डाउट अबाउट दैट, एंड एवरी कश्मीरी हैज अ पॉलिटिकल एस्पिरेशन. बट ईच एंड एवरी टाइम वी आर सीइंग दैट टू कम for a solution of Kashmir problem, a need to resolve it, there is a need of political dialogue between the both the countries, political dialogue within the different stakeholders in Kashmir. So the process and the Kashmiri problem have to be solved by following that major only. But consistently from last 4 years we have seen, like, this government, it is वो तो बातचीत करने का तो सवाल आप छोड़ दीजिए.
तो आपको क्या लग रहा है, मैंने ये सवाल साकिब से भी पूछा था कि बस बीजेपी को रिजेक्ट करने के लिए, जैसे आपने बताया कि कश्मीरी लोग जो है वो बहुत ज़्यादा डिजेक्टेड हो गए बीजेपी गवर्नमेंट से, बस बीजेपी को रिजेक्ट करने के लिए क्या इस बार कश्मीरी लोग बाहर आके वोट करेंगे?
सी सर्टनली लोगों को इस वक्त जो हम देख रहे हैं पूरी कंट्री में, मतलब बीजेपी और पर्टिकुलरली जो इसका एजेंडा है कश्मीर पर, तो सर्टनली मेरा जो अपना पर्सनल राय है, मैं जो लोग हैं ना कि कश्मीर में जम्मू में लद्दाख में हर जगह पे लोगों को वोट करना चाहिए बीजेपी के अगेंस्ट में और जितना बेहतर होगा स्टेट के लिए कि बीजेपी को हम जम्मू कश्मीर लद्दाख से बाहर रखें एंड फॉर दैट पीपल हैव टू वोट एंड सर्टनली वी हैव सीन द मेन सिटिंग पार्टीज इन कश्मीर वेदर दैट इज नेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस दैट इज पीडीपी आर सम अदर पार्टीज दे हैव फेल्ड डेफिनेटली दे हैव फेल्ड फ्रॉम लास्ट 3
डिकेड्स एंड न्यू पार्टी हैज कम इन द फ्रे शाह फैजल जेकेपी व्हाट डू यू वांट टू से अबाउट दैट
See, he is not contesting Lok Sabha elections. But so right now, we don't know how many people are going to go ahead and vote for them. But I think as far as I understand it, there is a certain kind of dilemma in the minds of people in terms of his agreement with the Indian election system. And, you know, those who boycott elections obviously are not supporting him on that level. But on the other hand, there is the fact that he is someone who is he is an intelligent man and he is obviously representing the he aspires to represent the voice of the youth and the people. So to some extent people are also going to support him for that. But I think it really
important
depends.
Question to you, Saqib. Dignity in death, not in living. Kashmiri youth sees dignity in death, not in living.
That is the thing that worries me the most when people and when especially the youths, we talk of youths, then when they see dignity in death and they don't see dignity in living, this is the most worrying thing, and this is something that will slip Kashmir out from the hands of India and even from the hands of Pakistan. I would go to the extent of saying this because we have seen that the youths of the Kashmir, there's a narrative going on in Kashmir that they are rejecting the Indian mainstream politics, they are rejecting the narrative of Pakistan, they are taking it upon themselves. And the movements which we have seen post 2016 are the ones, they are leaderless movements, the youths have taken upon themselves. And this sense of
rejecting Indian politics, Saqib said that youth jo hai wo Indian politics ko reject kar raha hai. Humne jab youth news click ne jab youth se baat ki, unhone bola unko koi farak nahi padta BJP aata hai ya koi aur party aata hai. Aur aap baat karte hai ki BJP ko reject karne ke liye unko vote karna chahega. Dono contradiction mein aap kya kehna chahenge is pe?
Oh, certainly dekhiye, chahe log Jammu Kashmir Ladakh ke log chahe vote karenge ya nahi karenge, phir bhi sarkar Jammu Kashmir mein banegi, MPs wahan se jayenge aur jo aane wale jo assembly election honge usme bhi government will be there. But the most important thing is, of course, we have a certain criticisms towards the mainstream parties in Kashmir, whether that is National Conference, PDP, as well as some other parties. They have failed from last 3 decades consistently in their memorandums, in their agendas, and what they were saying on the Kashmir, and they have been easily handpicked by the centre, and centre had used them in whatever means they. But the most important thing is, in this time, we have to think that what kind of a government we want in Jammu Kashmir and Ladakh. Does we want BJP back? जिसने हवे को 2 दिन बैन किया है, does we want such kind of a government which has lynched the people mercilessly?
पर youth government, youth India के साथ खुद को नहीं देखते हैं, उस पे आप क्या बोलेंगे?
I think most definitely that is a strong political affiliation of a lot of people, where they don't identify with any political party of India because they reject the whole system and they say that, you know, we want an alternative. So that way, whether it's a BJP or a Congress, they would not go and.
अगर youth alternative की बात करता है, तो क्या alternative? कौन सा alternative?
Alternatives will come once we start debating things, once we start discussing things, once we start discussing the conflict. And as I say, before we start talking about the realization of our political aspirations.
Is Azadi an alternative which youth of Kashmir talks about?
Let's first, you know, define what Azadi is. What does it mean? It's for the youths to decide and debate on this. What Azadi is. What kind of a political formation, state formation do they want? What kind of a relation do they want with the state of India, with the state of Pakistan? It's for them to decide what it is and what it would be like. It's for them to decide.
Get Kashmir. Does it want to make a point on this?
We are seeing it consistently. Kashmir is a political problem, and to solve the Kashmir.
Alternative
is a dialogue. Alternative is a dialogue. And a peaceful resolution of the issue.
Dialogue between who?
Dialogue between India, Pakistan, dialogue between the different stakeholders in Kashmir. Whether that is mainstream, whether that is separatist, whether that jo bhi hai, sabke saath baat kiya jaye aur Kashmir issue ko resolution ki tarah liya jaye.
Mera aakhri sawal aap teenon se ye hai ki if there is a metaphor to describe Kashmir, you know, if there is a metaphor to describe the relationship between Kashmiri youth and the Indian state, what would it be? अगर आपको एक मेटाफर में डिस्क्राइब करना है, क्या होगा कश्मीरी यूथ और इंडियन स्टेट के बीच में रिलेशनशिप को?
मैरिज विदाउट निकाह नामा.
नहीं, लाइक वी कैन नॉट डिस्कस इट इन मेटाफर, बट Certainly, Kashmiri youth towards India, it is the most problematic thing. And how the center has deal in this Kashmir and how the youth has been suffered consistently.
It does you mean that the center has failed in last 4 years to address what the youth wants?
Yes, definitely.
What do you think of the metaphor, the question I asked?
It's a very peculiar kind of relationship, because while there is obviously a deep resentment towards what is their personal experiences both in Kashmir and outside, where there is a military occupying them in that area when they're in Kashmir, and then when they come out, the kind of the what the media is saying about them and what the way people interact with them, so obviously they are confused.
Like, there are the memories of pain in Kashmir, and those memories of pain have been constantly coming in the memories of youth of Kashmir, and such memories are constantly like they are bridging a gap. And if you can see the New Delhi has not been able to address such memories, such pains which the youth have suffered. So certainly that is a problem in Kashmir.
How is a Kashmiri woman you see this election, and what are your expectations out of this election?
So with respect to Kashmiri women, I don't know if I can make a statement about them as a homogeneous group. I think just as there are individual political affiliations of Kashmiris, Kashmiri women also have a diverse set of political affiliations. Most definitely the problem affects them in a certain different manner as compared to a Kashmiri man. And just like there are different political affiliations of a Kashmiri man, Kashmiri women also seek to address their issues through different channels. So women will go out and vote if they feel that this is how their issues are going to be addressed, while there will be women who will boycott elections because they feel that that's the way their issues
First
are going to be.
First woman chief minister was Mehbooba Mufti in Kashmir. What do you think happened in her tenure?
Definitely, it is a statement where there is a female representative in power. But it is not to say that a female representative means that they are going to address all issues of women. It's a symbolic existence more than a representative existence, in the sense that to what extent are they going to address, because as far as, you know, how many people were blinded by pellets, how many women lost their husbands and sons. So I think to what extent was she able to address that, because, you know, a Kashmiri woman has that identity in Kashmir as well. So most definitely it was symbolic in the sense that there is a female representative, but I don't think she was able to address issues of Kashmiri women.
Thanks for joining us. To get more updates, follow Newsclick.